Alright guys, I just went to the store today and bought two 160s, 110, and a coil spring foothold trap. It's really windy out right now, so yeah. We're down setting traps. We got two set right now, and then this one's set. This is a 160, brand new, down on a slide. We got weeds surrounding both sides. We got that down there, right there, covered up. So we're hoping we'll catch something in that. Looks like where they maybe just go up and eat, not for sure. We have one more 160 and a 110 to set, and I'll show you my other 110 and my foothold trap where that's positioned at up next. So this is my first 160 setup of the day. We'll see you guys later. You guys can hardly see it down there, but that's my new 110 conibear set in a funnel in the stream. Gets together and there's a little funnel. So hoping to maybe have a muskrat or something go crawling through there. A mink maybe swimming down that stream and catch him by that 110 conibear. We got it staked up right there and right there. So that's trap number two, and we have five traps set out, and we'll get to them later. See you guys later. Alright guys, we got our 220 conibear right here. It's not set yet, I'm just about to set it. We got this little slide down here for muskrat.
Sorry.
It's set. Just take it like so. Squeeze them together. I found out that these are much harder than the 110s, obviously. So you have to be careful with these. Alright. She's set. Take the safeties off just in case it does come out. It's still gonna kind of hurt, but I'm gonna set it right down in here. Let me get a stake pounded in. About right there. It's nice and mushy, so you wanna make sure it's pounded in quite a ways.
Darn, I think I'm gonna go to the other side.
Over there?
Yeah.
Alright, he's going to stop the video, he's going to go over there so you can see a little bit better, then we'll continue on.
Stop it?
Yep. Alright guys, we got reposition on our back, we got my stake right there. In this water, it's a little
murky,
muddy, so don't want to get stuck in the mud, obviously. Just stick that right under there.
The heck was that?
The mud?
Oh. You can hardly see it from over here.
Put right on through there. There's little holes in this stake. I'm gonna stick a stick right through there.
So it don't come out.
It's gonna have a trouble time out, getting out. Might actually break it.
That's what you just did. Jordan, you have a stick right in your hand. Alright, since I'm kind of just wasting your time, I'll have him stop the video in a second. All I'm going to do is I'm just going to put a stick through here so they can't escape from that. And then kind of just blend it in. I'll get another video or a picture or a video at the end showing what it looks like. So he's going to stop the video and look at it. You guys can't really see it, but we're done with it. It's kind of right in there. Well, that's what it looks like at the end. You guys can hardly see it, so it's good blend in. Right now we're setting up the 110, so we'll see you guys later. Bye. All right, down here we have our, sorry about that, our number one coil spring trap. We got a nice little going right there. They go right on along in there. We're going to set a 110. Right there, under that little twig right there. And that'll be all of our traps. We have our first one right there. We got a coil spring right there. We got three of them right down there. So we'll see you guys later. Here's conibear 110 trap number two that we have set up in this little walkway right here. It's right down in there under this twig. That looks perfect. It's either mink or muskrat walking that trail right there. And they're going to have to go under that twig. That conibear is right there. It's going to get them right there. And if they're going to come in at this side, we have a number one Duke coil spring right on down in there. That'll also get them. Then we have a couple more down there. Three more down there. So we have five traps set up. We have one more trap to show you after this. It's a spring. Or not a spring, but it's a snare trap. He bought with his money, so we're going to show you that, and that should be it for the day. We'll be out here tomorrow checking all these traps. Hopefully we'll have at least one. Thanks for watching. We'll show you this one more trap real quick, and we'll see you there. All right, this is Jace here. He's my brother, and he's going to be out trapping with us sometimes, checking the traps and setting the traps. He's going to have his own little traps going, so Jace will tell you what he has, and how much it was and everything.
Well, right here, you got a snare for a small game. You just set it in a hole and have it kind of a little smaller than the hole. Like, there needs to be trees by it so you can tie it to a tree. Make sure they can't get on out of it. And then once they come on walking through here, they'll get stuck and they'll be yanking on it. And
demonstrate that for them. Pull it out and use your hand and demonstrate.
Like, they'll be, say this is the hole they'll be going, then they'll get caught. They'll be going, this will be on around their neck and get caught by their neck.
Now this is a legitimate snare trap that he bought at a store. You can also make one homemade with kind of not too thick of wire, but thin wire or even string. But this is only like $1 something at any trapping supply store. So I recommend getting one of these. It's good. Pretty much a coyote snare, but you can use it for anything. As you can see, it's really long. So you could use it from coyote to coon to anything.
Yeah, so I like these kind of snacks or traps better on footholds and conibears and all those, because I don't know why, I like them better. I like these kind.
All right, that's it for today. We'll check these six traps tomorrow, and we'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching. All right, guys, I'm going to show you how to make a simple snare loop if you want to make a snare trap. Also, I have a string right here, or you can use wire. This is if you don't have any money on you and you want to make an easy loop instead of going to buy one. Even though I do recommend buying them because they're just set up way better, all right? But if you don't, these work just as good. So you take it through, take your string, and you just loop it like that. Put your string through, pull it together just a little bit. You want a hole, then you want to do the same thing again, but not in the same hole. Okay, and then you put your pinky in there,
pull it tight, just like that. It's that simple. You want to make sure this is tight. Mine's not that tight though. So that's all you do. Now you got your snare loop. Alright. You can also find out how to do this online. Alright, the video got canceled, so I don't know how, but. So, I'm set up with the loop here. Just like that. And then you take it through the string. Like so. You got your snare. Alright. So make sure to check out all my other videos. I'll see you guys later.